Hey everybody, it's Connor. Listen, we learned over the weekend that Google has delayed the release of Gemini, this ChatGPT killer, into the new year. And I just want to say this respectfully. Google, what is happening inside that beautiful ping-pongy campus of yours? What is Sundar Pichai doing? And look, I'm not going to be the first idiot that's going to bet against Google, because I bet Gemini is going to be phenomenal and Sundar Pichai is a genius and all of that. You know, what's the big deal? I mean, GPTs were delayed. Everything gets delayed. This is why this matters. Google walks into every wrestling match as the 800-pound gorilla. I mean, they have 92% of search. They own email. Like a year ago, though, this giant 800-pound gorilla was caught off guard by OpenAI. And look, that's fine. That can happen. So they totally went code red, with Sundar Pichai reportedly directing like all these teams within the company to refocus their efforts on generative AI, et cetera, right? And everyone's like, okay, here we go, game on. And this is just going to be the end of the road because, Google has 200,000 people and OpenAI only has a few hundred people. So here we go, right? What actually happens? They launch Bard and everybody's like, woo, Bard. And everybody's like, Google, smash, right? And ChatGPT is going to get wasted. So what happens? Well, in the debut, the live demo, Bard made stuff up about the James Webb telescope that you could easily find on the NASA website. And we might say, yeah, poor guy, sometimes these things hallucinate. But like, then pick a different example, man. Like, run that demo like 1,000 times, because that is not a small mistake. Google's parent company Alphabet lost $100 billion off their market cap that day. That is kind of a big deal, but fine, it's a stumble. And if that had just been like a bad moment on stage, fine. But here we are a year later, which is an eternity in AI, and Bard is still woefully behind. It never caught up, it never came close. So why does that matter? Well, it matters because startups shouldn't be able to compete with the 800-pound gorilla. It is the advantage of being the 800-pound gorilla. And it feels like Google hasn't just taken their foot like off the gas. It feels like they've like pulled off the highway and gone into like a Denny's or something and ordered like Moons Over Miami and are enjoying their coffee. And meanwhile, on the motorway outside, Anthropic has raced into second place. I mean, Anthropic's upgraded Claude like twice in the last 3 weeks, like real significant upgrades. And Inflection is the same. Inflection now says they're second only to GPT-4 by their metrics. And I mean, Grok is making headway. And Elon Musk's big selling point is that it's sort of snarky, right? I mean, what is happening here? Listen, delays happen. They do. And we can say that Gemini is going to be a game changer and will race to compete with GPT-4, may even outperform it. But if Google had the leadership it needed over the last 12 months, it's very possible we may have never even heard of these companies. Instead, OpenAI and Anthropic and Inflection are valued at billions of dollars. So again, this is fine. Everybody's like, fine, no problem. Google still owns all our workflows. Okay, but how much have you been reading about like Google Duet of late, right? Like, yeah, me neither, man. Or how about Microsoft Copilot? That's what's in the news right now. That's what everybody's talking about. And then we might say, oh, well, Google still has 92% of search and it brought in, what was it? It was $162 billion in revenue last year. Yeah, except search is changing, friends. And that is not good for Google, because it's like 57% of Google annual revenue is just search and ads and everything like that. Because you are not going to be able to count on that, because in a world where people are looking up stuff using natural language processing and large language models, that is an ad killer. It will change SEO forever. And although also, that's not like a distant, ridiculous prospect. And I can't believe I'm saying this right now, but I don't even really use Google search anymore, which is, it's like saying I don't use my teeth anymore, right? But now here's the thing. I now use things like Perplexity, which is powered by GPT and Claude, and it gives way better answers exactly as I wanted, and it searches like a dozen links and all that kind of stuff. Google search feels archaic to me now. That might be a different episode. Speaking of which, if you wouldn't mind subscribing, it would be awesome. I would love it. Please do subscribe. Anyway, I'm not saying Gemini won't be great. I'm saying that Google has way bigger problems. Let's keep an eye on this together.